Welcome back, guys, to a new Boom Bitch video, and we are doing pretty good. So we've worked our way all the way up to rank 13 there, almost touching rank 14 there. Hopefully we'll get in there in today's video and grab that lovely rank chest. And in terms of the tech tree, we've got one chest there, and I think we're just going to keep moving forward. And what we're going to do is we did go ahead down here grabbing those cannons. We're going to unlock the next engine room, and then we're going to go back this way, grab those shock mines for sure. And then in terms of this multi-node, we have one multi-node over there as well. So what I think I'm going to do is, because there's a building health over here as well, and there's building health over here, I might pick the building damage for this one and then the building health for that one, because I do want to like balance it out there. Building damage is certainly going to help once we get those, you know, maxed rockets there. It's going to help our defense, and then building health obviously slow the opponent down a bit more there. So that's going to be the plan. We're going to go straight there. Shock mines to, you know, slow them down. Absolutely. They're going to be critical. That's definitely going to be the next node that we want to unlock after grabbing the next engine room. And in terms of log is looking quite good over here as well. I'll show you one of my faster times over here. I think it was, 250. So this one was one of my faster times. So because we unlocked flares and the smokes, we upgraded the smokes as well, we were able to do this type of attack strategy. He has all of his end rooms at the back, and we could simply bypass all of his defenses there using battle orders there. We don't need the heavy to survive for that long, just eat the damage for a little while, and there it is there. So that was a nice attack that we can sometimes do if all the end rooms are clustered at the back there. So let's hop into another battle over here. I'm going to switch this over to Iron Will there, so that's going to be good. And if there's no mines or anything, I'll do battle orders, but if there is mines, I'll typically pick Iron Will. Okay, let's see, he's got an engine underneath the sky shield, and this base, I think, let's take a look at his stats for a second as well. Build a troop health, troop damage, but no building health or building damage. Okay, so I think what I'm just going to do is, let's go ahead with a battle orders there, and we'll just do a split attack here. 1-2, 1-2 there, and 1-2. And I think I'll drop Brick on this side over here, because I think she might be closer. These groups might be closer to that engine room over there. And once we activate Battle Orders there, they'll hopefully, you know, increase speed and increase damage there. Will help out quite a bit there. I just hope that these Zookas don't die too much from these mines. So, yeah, hoping that we don't lose too many there. Okay. Ooh, losing a lot of Zookas there. And now they're splitting up to those darn machine guns down there. Okay, let's activate battle orders there, get them moving and grooving there. Okay, he's got a sniper tower, I mean not a sniper tower, a Simo. Let's activate another battle orders, and at this point it's just, you know, we're just going to keep on activating battle orders. There's nothing else we can use our GB on that would be as effective as battle orders, of course. So let's get ready to flare now. And I think they're going to be already on it. Let's just do another battle orders instead. And 2 minutes 57. Don't think he's going to be able to beat that. Yeah, he's retreated. So let's take a look. Only if he has artillery. So he went Grenadiers. And with the Sky Shield there, protecting that end room. Grenadiers are a little bit hard there. They do get a little bit of slower time. So we'll hop back into it right there. And we got the rank chest as well. Nice. So that's going to help out in unlocking the shock bombs in the next attack. So over here, let's see what does he have. He's only got 80% troop damage. Okay, that's good. So we can just use battle orders. And what I'm going to do is, actually, I'm just going to bring one more Zooka just for the damage, actually. Let's see. And yeah, let's just come down from here. With all this damage, we should be able to get through it pretty quick. We do have to go through every single defense. So that's why I'm just bringing in one more extra boat of Zookas, of course. So delay drop that one heavy there, and we'll let them walk up first. I don't want to activate battle orders just yet, so we'll let them take down some of these buildings. So the 80% troop damage, and right about now there, as soon as they come into the reach of all these other defenses, hopefully those mortar shells aren't going to be able to target the hit too many of our Zookas there. And I'm not sure yet. I'll just keep activating battle orders here instead of trying to flare to the end room. Perhaps I could. Yeah, at this point, yeah, let's just go. Let's flare. That laser beam is not going to be able to hurt us too much there. And let's get preemptively flared there. Yeah, they take down the building so fast that you do have to preemptively flare just in the right time there. 2 minutes, 1 second, guys. That's probably my fastest time yet, actually. Let's see what he's going to do. 2 minutes, 50, 49. Yeah, he's got a mix of Reifman as well. Okay. And Brick died early on, so that was their sweet defense here. So things are looking good. Like, I'm sure if we, played for like 2 hours straight, we could get into diamond. But, I typically play when there's chests to collect, or else I play a couple of times when we have troops. So let's grab that. And I'm hoping we do have enough for keys for shocks afterwards. So let's go into the next engine room. And no, we don't. Okay. So we needed one more chest there. But it doesn't matter. I'm gonna. Let's take a look. No, wait. I almost forgot this one. Let's grab this one. Rank chest. And hopefully that's gonna be enough. Yes, it is now. Is barrage gonna be. It's a choice between barrage and the shocks. I think I'm gonna go with the shocks because, the troops are gonna be stunned. And everyone's using ground troops right now. So they're gonna be the better choice rather than getting the barrage there. So let's get that. So that was a good unlock there. And let's take a look at what the local, not the local one. I don't think anyone here is at the next engine room yet. Perhaps they are. Yeah, a lot of people are still at four engine rooms. So let's take a look at what the global warship looks like. Okay, so he's doing completely clustered because he does have those rocket launchers. He's got the building health, building damage, so I can't do a base like that. But I'm gonna do my best, create a base, and we'll be right back in a second here, guys. And we're back. So I just made a quick five engine base. Now we don't know what type of base is gonna be best in five engines, like what type of base layout, but here it is. I'm doing the best with my defenses over here. And the basic idea here, I guess, is like trying to bring them together up the center here and up there, and hopefully leaving that area, that engine room, to the last, because obviously he can't flare to it. He's gonna have to let his troops free clear over there. So that's the plan anyway. Let's hop into an attack here, do our first few battles in five engine rooms and see how it goes. We should have the engine room advantage because we're extremely early here. We've decided to rush into five engine rooms. It feels like yesterday we literally just got into four engine rooms. So yeah, we're just gonna keep moving forward, getting the next nodes, and hopefully that's gonna help us go up in rank and into gold soon enough here. So don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, guys, if you guys are regular viewers. I do appreciate that. Okay, here, so nice win. So let's just grab it. Nothing here. Let's go and just do one activator off the bat there, and we're gonna crush this player clearly. I'm not sure. I didn't see his stats actually, so maybe he's got a lot of troop damage or troop defense or something. But yeah, let's just hop straight into it, and this is the engine room advantage that we wanted. So this guy was only at two engine rooms, so we're quite low for where we really should be, to be honest. So that's why we're getting ranked, we're getting matched up with these really low level players right now. But I'm not complaining. We're on a small 3x win streak, so let's keep that going here. Okay, here it is. This is our first actual battle over here, and let's just do a split attack. And one there, one. Okay, and I think I'll activate. I'm not sure where to activate battle orders. Maybe I should have used Iron Will over here because he does have a Doom Cannon. But let's see. We have to drop them down split attack or else we'd get an extremely slow time here. So let's see. We don't have artillery or anything to take out these mines. So hopefully these heavies do a good job and take out the mines in front of them, please. Yes. Okay, that's nice. And down here, please. Okay, I think most of them are gone there. Let's activate battle orders here. We don't have any Iron Will or anything, so we gotta activate spam battle orders to take down the defenses before all the heavies die in the front line here. So let's go, Brick. Go on, Brick. Okay, Brick has not been targeted yet. That's nice. Okay, and another one, guys. And let's just flare over to the last one, please. I know there's a machine gun there, but 2 minutes 57, 56. 55. Okay, he didn't have shock mines there actually, so that helped. That helped us quite a bit. Let's see, what does he have? Okay, he's got some heavies over there. He can't flare. he's having to do a ground flare instead, and that's just going to slow him down a bit more. So this is exactly what we wanted there. Unfortunately, he didn't go through those two shock mines, so we might have to move those two shock mines. But yeah, the base is working, at least in this first attack over here. And yeah, he's going to get slow time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move this mine and put this mine somewhere in the middle over here. And that's clearly got me the path where they're going to go. And I might move that one too. I'm not sure. I'll just leave this one hidden underneath there. And yeah, I'll leave that one there. Okay, so that's looking good. Let's get right into another battle if we can. 4x windsheet, that's nice. Hopefully we can get another rank chest over here. But let's find another opponent and see what we can do. Okay, he's at rank 15. Okay, he's at 3 end rooms, even better over here. So I think, yeah, let's just go on this side. There's less mines to go. And I should have actually switched out a heavy for another Zuka there as well. But, you know, I think we should do well either way, to be honest. Let's go. So yeah, we're extremely lucky to get to have rushed into 5 end rooms here. We're getting matched up with a lot of player who are at even 2 and 3 end rooms. Wow. So we got to make the best use of it and do as many attacks as we can and climb up the ranks. So let's just keep spamming battle orders here. Now we can't flare, so we just got to save up GB. And now we can flare this. Okay, no, let's just activate battle orders there. Truman's 22, absolutely unstoppable time. And this 3 engine player won't know what hit him. And okay, yeah, let's see. So he's using Grenz there, Zukus, and even Rifeman as well. Okay, so that's interesting. And he's chosen to artillery out this engine over here. Okay, yeah, that means that he only has to go around this way and up there. Straightforward path, but still gonna be too slow for us right now. He does have artillery to take out the shock mines and regular mines as well, so. You know, he does have some good tech. And he's doing another battle orders there. Troops are getting shocked. And Brick is getting shocked there too. The mines aren't doing as much damage as I would have hoped to his troops. Maybe he does have the troop health or something. But yeah. So half his troops are splitting up. He's having to do another flare, guys. And maybe I should put a mortar there or something. But yeah. So that's pretty good. And we might just do one more attack if we have it there. That's a 5x win streak, so that's pretty nice there. Let's go ahead, we'll do another one. Let's just take a look at the tech tree while we're waiting, of course. Yeah, next up we'll just grab this one over here, get the building damage like I said, and over here we'll grab the building health just to balance it out there. So 5x win streak, lovely stuff there. Let's get 6x right now. Okay, he doesn't have any defenses. That means he must have something on offense, like a ton of stuff on offense. Actually, what I'll do is just bring one more as well. And let's ensure to bring battle orders. Okay, let's do one, two, three, and one, there. And I think let's just drop them over here. So he does have the rocket launchers. I'm not sure. I didn't check his building damage or anything, but I am a bit nervous. Even though his base looks easy, he's probably going to get a pretty quick time over here against us. So let's see, maybe I should have gone and met some medics there to out heal the rocket launcher damage. But let's just go keep activating some more battle orders. And if we can move faster than the rocket launchers can hit us. Oh, there it is. They're hitting us from the side up there. That's not what we want. Come on, we have quite a lot of Zukas though. So go on, guys. And one more. The next one's going to be 54, so I don't think we're going to be able to save up for that. So let's see what we can do. They're quite clustered right now, so they're extremely vulnerable to these rocket launcher salvos right now. And we're going to flare the last one. Okay. I'm not sure. He probably has rockets, actually. Rocket choppers. So that could be something. We're going to hit that mine as well. Okay, not too many of our Zukas got shocked there. And 2 minutes, what are we going to get? 44, 43. Okay, 243. I think that's still decent. We'll see in a second. 2 minutes, 43. He's got, okay, yeah. And got rocket choppers here. Only the sky shield is helping us. 2 minutes, 43. No. I'm not sure. We're so close there. There's a few more seconds and we probably would have gotten it there. But of course, the space is geared towards defending against ground troops and not the rocket choppers yet, guys. So yeah, we did what we could there. I think we were extremely close there. So if I was defending against rocket choppers there, I would actually move some of these cannons over here. So I'll move that one over there, actually, just to defend against that type of attack in the future. So I'll move this one over there. And yeah, so always watch your replays and change your base as needed to those to defend. So guys, that's it gonna be from me today, and don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.